younger people, and of course they don't really like the classroom. They would be much happier learning online, which is probably true. And you have to look at the age of your employees as well. And if you're hiring young people, certainly I think you can look at e-learning, you can look at the internet as a really good way to approach it, and lowering the cost. If you're recruiting more baby boomers, then maybe you need to spend the time and the cost for the classroom. But I think even some old people like me, they like to learn on the internet. The problem really with the internet, with e-learning, is most of it has been very bad. And maybe later this afternoon I can show you some good e-learning. It's fun and it's good. But most e-learning is we just took the classroom, we videotaped the content, and we put me on the computer. And I'm just as boring on the computer as I am in the classroom. So, you know, you just move the board up, but you don't change the whole thing. So you have to change the definition. And that's a hard thing to do, but you really have to do that if you're going to be effective with your work. Yeah, sure. The IBM is obviously a big company with a lot of resources. The training department is quite large, so they can spend a lot of time to do this kind of thing, and they develop the e-learning and so forth. But there are resources available for small companies too. And you don't have to be IBM to do this. You can be smaller and still to do this. And we can talk about some of that later. So I think that, you know, if you look at what IBM says, this is from IBM's website. And I like this very much. IBM's learning strategy needs to support the company's new business imperatives. So by the way, they're saying our training supports our business. That's what we're all about. So that's the first thing. And I have a vision. Okay? Our vision for IBM is to be an environment where it's easy for employees to learn what they need. So the first thing, easy to learn what you need. That's the first part of their vision. When they need it. So again, the classroom, no flexibility. You have to go and buy schedule business whenever you need it. And apply your knowledge, understanding, and experience for your own benefit as well as IBM's. So that's the vision for the learning program. And when you have that vision, that immediately the classroom becomes not so important. And you have to have a lot of online and e-learning and other kinds of internet-based education in order to achieve your vision. So if we go back to my picture at the beginning with the vision. So this is the vision. And then you say, how do we get there? Well, one of the things to get there is to put in place e-learning. And must have e-learning in place in order to achieve the thing. And then we have some specific goals for learning. Leverage intellectual capital to grow our knowledge base. So this is enable collaboration among employees. So how do you do this? You help the employees talk to each other, get together, share their information on the internet. So within IBM, they have a big database of information. It's sort of like a chat room where employees can say, I work at this customer today and I have this problem. And then all the IBM employees in the world can say, oh yeah, I have the same problem before and this is the way I solved that problem. So you can learn from everybody in the world about different problems that you have and they can share their knowledge around the world. So this requires a computer infrastructure, requires the chat room so that you can put this in place. But that's part of the learning organization. And if you ask people, where does the chat room come from? Usually they say from IT. It shouldn't come from IT, it should come from the learning function. It's part of the learning function responsibility. Speed the transfer of knowledge. So again, the same thing, this chat room and so forth, you have to speed up that delivery of information from me to you and using it in real time. And ensure that they reach the target audience and meet their needs. So they have to employ the right technologies to do that. They have to measure what they do. And they have to constantly say, after you went through this training program, what can you do that's different? And did you do it? And they measure, did you do it, right? And we'll talk about measurement in this afternoon. But an important part of this is to measure if you did it. And most of our training, in my experience in corporate world, you have a training class, and you fill out, you have a license, food was good, and that's it. You don't measure anything else, right? And 2 years or 3 years later, nobody knows if it was useful or not useful. So you have to measure it. How do you measure it 1 year later or 6 months later? How do you measure it? And that will rank the learning with business results. What was the result of the business of this learning? If I spent $20,000 training him, what did IBM get for that? And you have to kind of figure out, was it worth spending that money? Was there anything to get anything for it? So this is a good, I think, a really good case study of the skill development kind of process that you can have in place if you're going to use this kind of corporate university. McDonald's has the same thing. So when you go to McDonald's University, even though you must go there, you know, why does McDonald's University make you go there? Why don't they do it on the learning? That's right. You have to be there to experience it. You can't make a sandwich on the internet. You have to actually be there to do it. So you have to have the right training for the right purpose. Right? So if you're teaching somebody how to make something, you probably need a classroom. You need a place to go. But if you're teaching about ideas or concepts or things, then you don't need to do that. Okay? So you have to understand, what am I trying to do here? So McDonald's needs to have a physical place. And they teach you how to actually do it. They have real customers who come in and talk to you, so you can learn how to talk to a customer. So it's a real experience, not something you can do. You can't really do that very hungry. You can't do it. Yeah, we do. It's, you can, certain things you can learn to do, like the airline teach the pilots how to fly in a computer, right? Computer simulation. But someday you have to get in the airplane, and you actually have to fly the airplane. I was talking with the U.S. Air Force, and when they teach the pilots to fly the airplane, they learn all their flying, all the training is in the computer simulator. And the first day they fly a real airplane, they're all alone, because there's only 1 seat in the airplane. So there's no seat for an instructor, no seat for anybody. So you actually go up in this plane the first time ever, you ever fly, and there are all other stuff. I would be so scared. But they're all successful because the computer simulator is very, very good. It's exactly the same as being there. But it would still be pretty scary for me. They teach them all, and this airplane costs a lot of money. If they lose it, big loss, so they said, you can have no mistake. We lose one person and we lose one airplane if our training is not good. So they measure the results immediately. And, you know, if they crash, then they obviously were not successful. So it's very quick feedback on your training ability. But so you can train many things in the simulation, but it costs a lot of money to do that. It's a lot of effort. The second type is the strategic business focus. And this is a very interesting kind of corporate university. And this one is really Motorola University. This is Motorola University. What was Motorola University founded to do? Anybody know the charter and purpose? One day, CEO of Motorola says, I think we need to have a corporate university to do one thing, to create quality. Quality was the reason for Motorola University. So he said, our products are low quality. We must improve the quality of our products to compete with Japan. And so in 1980-something, when Japan was very strong in the U.S., and American products were not very good quality, Motorola said, we have to create this university in order to train every employee about quality. And that's where Six Sigma came from. All of these programs came from Motorola University. That's the only thing it does. It doesn't teach you how to make a mobile phone. It doesn't teach you leadership or management skills.